seen over the past few months an uptick in new building ordering activity, both internationally and from Greek owners.
Yeah.
Why is that the case? Why are we seeing a shift from the wait and see stance to let's act more aggressively now in the market? Is the factor of elevated prices one of the reasons?
Yes. Shipyards at the moment in China, for example, are considering to increase the price even more. It's a matter of supply and demand. The slot availability at the moment in China is somewhere between late 27, beginning 28. There are only a few slots available for the VIP owners, clients that they have each individual shipyard. And therefore, there is a need, and because there is a need to increase to increase the dead weight of the capacity of bulk carriers and tankers, and there is an aging fleet as well at the same time, ship owners are now eager to find slots, and therefore we have this madness at the moment in order book activity.
Okay. Is it also a case of starting to renew the fleet in order to make it
absolutely
compliant?
Absolutely. We have a very aging fleet, especially in bulkers and tankers. Just imagine the bulkers that were built in 2006 between 2010. By 2028, they will be 20 years old. So these vessels are definitely not compliant anymore. And therefore, we have this increase in the order book as well.
Do you also see EU ETS acting as an accelerator?
It could be, yes. Yes, it's another issue as well. They try to make the vessels more compliant, offset, try to create this pooling to offset from the non-compliant vessels as well, and the credit taxation thing that exists. And therefore, also that's it's a combination of several different factors, basically, that take place.
In terms of the attempt to future-proof a vessel, is this possible today?
Future-proof
against new regulations and making a ship as compliant as possible.
Yes, it is possible. There are designs at the moment that are developed to make the vessels compliant for the future. We are talking about ships where methanol dual fuel vessels at the moment are in the water. We see container ships actually being able to burn methanol. There's a lot of development on the ammonia readiness and the capability. The question we have at the moment is the supply chain of the fuels. And I think this is the biggest challenge the industry is facing at the moment. We need a lot of investments. We need, as an industry, from now on, we need to come out to investors and openly claim that we need the infrastructure, we need the fuel capacity, the fuel in terms of volume, so that then the owners can make a decision on what kind of fuels they're going to use based on the trading patterns.
So a ship that is being ordered today and being delivered, let's say, in a couple of years,
yeah,
and it will have a lifespan of at least 15 years, so until 2040.
Yes.
How will it be able to trade and be compliant at the same time? Is LNG a solution?
LNG is a transitional fuel, cannot consider as a permanent solution.
Yeah.
There are definitely technologies that can support the transition of LNG to an alternative fuel. There are different solutions that we are working and we are considering as classification societies as well. We are suggesting and we are supporting the shipyards. At the moment, the best solution we have for an owner that is not convinced on the solution that he needs to follow, a high-performing, efficient vessel with conventional fuel and a form of readiness on ammonia methanol will help him to keep the vessels compliant. And when the supply chain is defined, he can then make a decision to retrofit his vessels to the future fuel.
Yeah, that's-